make contact again anyway, though. There's the real...
Oh, Grace Brown just hit one of the bumps in the middle of that roundabout. She goes straight over the top. She keeps her hopes alive, but she's got some chasing to do.
Well, that was a good recovery by Brown.
Oh, she looked like she actually just locked up her rear wheel. So a little panic, and then she grabbed a handful of front, which lifted her rear wheel off the ground. So it's a moment of panic there for Brown. But fortunately, she was able to recover.
Amazing recovery. Good work. And similarly by Kadzar going across country.
Real performance by the Kiwi.
All of them evading a crash. Very impressive. But it's played into the hands here of Elongo Borghini, who is a woman on a mission.
It's now created a split of two off the front. And Vollering again finds herself chasing with the anchor of Kasia Nuodoma. Elongo Borghini and Vollering with some conversation at the front. They're the two big stars of this leading group. Vollering, she's the defending champion. She had an extraordinary season last year.
And she'd love to turn this season around with a victory today. The fact that she hasn't won a race this year after such a dominant season last year, this would really get the monkey off the back.
There's the Flamme Rouge in the distance. Two right-hand turns to come, and then they can see the finish line. Elise Chabet, without the element of surprise, it is Longo Borghini who gets the slipstream. Now Grace Brown finds herself doing the work, chasing again.
She often does bridge, but it's with a huge cost to her own legs. So Chabet has done the work. Now we're going to see a counter from Kasia Nuodoma.
And is that the one, the straw that breaks the camel's back? Kim Kadzo, she's the next to respond to it. 1 kilometre remaining. Kasia Nuodoma is making her bid for victory.
Well, the other riders need Kadzo to close the gap, which they have done. Just slotting onto the wheel. So far, it's Demi Vollering who's done the least amount of work.
A good position for Brown to be in the slipstream of Longo Borghini.
It is, and Longo Borghini is in a great position, but she's going to need to launch soon enough because now Nuodoma's got a bit of a taste of victory. Just 700 metres to go.
And Longo Borghini has recognised it as Kadzo was not able to close the gap. So now the Italian champion has bridged across to Kasia Nuodoma. There's a small gap that has opened up to Kadzo. Nuodoma has been caught. Longo Borghini has got herself in the box seat. A quick look across the shoulder from the Kiwi in the pink colours, Kadzo. At the back of the group, the defending champion, Vollering, she has not panicked. Still looking for her first victory of the season. Grace Brown starts to open up the sprint, but she's got a lot of work to do. It's Longo Borghini who's gone long range in the sprints, and she is getting challenged by Brown, who's coming over the top. Brown, brilliant, wins Liège-Bastogne-Liège. From the day-long breakaway, claws her way over the top to victory.
Sensational there by the Australian. What a powerful finish. Those last pedal strokes getting over the top of Longo Borghini.
Well, it looked like it was all about to go wrong for Grace Brown with around 5 kilometres to race. She nearly lost her back wheel going through a roundabout, recovered from that, and this is the sprint.
And she started from a long way back here.
She did. She had to get across there to the wheel of Longo Borghini, who was so powerful in her initial acceleration. Then they both slow a little, and you can see Grace just coming around the right-hand side, Vollering, very fast finish. But you're right, she almost didn't have time for the celebration and the disbelief on her face. There she is, front on. You can see the explosion around the wheel of Longo Borghini.
Well, it was a long sprint, wasn't it? It looked like just everybody exploded around her, but she just persisted with her effort all the way to the line, past Longo Borghini, a small time in the saddle there as well before getting back out and kicking to the line.
And Vollering really just started her sprint too late and too far back. The sheer power there of Brown back in the saddle. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it was an amazing day. I wanted to be in that break. We always know that a strong break can go in the middle section of the race, and we worked really well together. I felt like on my limit on the climbs towards the end, but once I survived Rochefoucauld, I thought it's on. So good.
Grace Brown.
As you heard from the venue announcer, twice she's finished second at Liège-Bastogne-Liège. Twice she's finished second in the time trial at the World Championships, the Olympics of this year. It might be a good omen. It is Grace Brown who wins the eighth edition of Liège-Bastogne-Liège. It's slowly sinking in.
And I can imagine her husband, her family, everyone who's been around from the start of her career would be so bursting with pride for Grace Brown.